money. I need to wish money and someone wish money to me. Hey. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. And if this is your first time here, welcome. My name is Bibi and I'm the founder of Lady Biba. I've been running that business for about 8 years now, and I'm sharing my journey as a fashion entrepreneur and just general tips that can help you thrive as a business owner. We're talking about money. I mean, the shmoney dance. I'm wearing the shmoney green. So, in the past, we've had this hush-hush culture about money. People don't like to talk about money, and I find it very interesting because when you're at weddings, you're seeing people spray money. There's such a grandiose culture about spending money, especially with the Yoruba culture in Nigeria. But when it comes to talking about financial responsibility, I find that it's something that in the past we weren't very open. Last year, I decided that I was going to start being more financially responsible. So my relationship with money, I would say, is fairly good, or was fairly good. I've never been ostentatious or the one to like be about designers and like lavish lifestyle. I was never that type. But the funny thing is, even though I was frugal for the most part, I wasn't being financially responsible. So the ending of last year, I made up my mind that 2020 is the year to get my money right. So I've been reading about money, I've been reading finance resources, watching videos, just trying to educate myself. And I believe that that's the very first step in getting your money right, is educating yourself. I'm particularly interested in business owners and entrepreneurs because we tend to put ourselves last when it comes to money and financial gain, and it's quite understandable. You don't want to take too much money from your business, and you always want to put your business first, so you pay yourself last, you take pay cuts when the business is not doing really well, and so on and so forth. While these things are noble, you have to be intentional about building your own personal wealth. And I'll say the very first step is separating your personal finance from your business funds if you haven't been doing so already. You shouldn't be dipping in and out of your business account, and you should not have an ATM card on your business account because that will tempt you. You're out and you received, you see the menu and your budget is maybe 10k or 15k on a restaurant meal, or 5k or whatever your budget is, and you're with someone and the person is doing starters, they're doing main meal, and they're doing dessert, and instead of you to cut your clothes according to your fabric, not according to your size, now you're saying, let me just indulge. And that's where it really starts from. So you reach for your corporate card account and you use it to pay your bill, and you're like, you know what, I'll pay back later. And that's how it continues. You continue to dip into your business fund, and then you don't realize that you can't even pay back because you're barely surviving. So yeah, it's so important to separate your business finance from your personal funds. Another thing that you need to consider on the business finance aspect is that you need to pay yourself a salary. So you might not be able to pay yourself what you can afford, but you need to pay yourself something that's significant to cover your expenses and then leave some to save. So in this aspect, you might be thinking, oh, okay, I can't really afford to pay myself a significant, like something I can take care of myself, so I'd rather not pay myself. But the truth is, you will be dipping into the funds because you will have cost of upkeep. So even if your business, say your business did not make a good profit in a certain month, you can write it in your account as wages payable. So it means that your business is owing you money. Don't be greedy in this aspect. See what your business can really afford. It doesn't matter how much your contemporaries are earning. You have to look into your own business finance and see what is affordable for your business and what will also keep you. So now that we're done with the business finance aspect, I didn't really want to go into deep and more about the personal finance in this video. So here are some of the things that you need to consider for your personal finance. So some of the things that I deem as the most important things for your personal finance is 1, your general savings, 2, your emergency fund, 3, your health insurance, and 4, investments. So for me, these are the 4 things that I focused on. There are other things like pension, life insurance, and all other types of insurance, which I'm not going to talk about in this video. I'm going to focus on those 4 things. So when it comes to building personal wealth, I've seen a lot of people say, they have goals, like I want to build a house, I want to do this, I want to do that, but there's no plan. Like there's no concrete plan. And if you do not plan, you're definitely going to fail. You have to start laying down the foundation. It doesn't matter that you can't afford what you want eventually, but you have to lay the foundation of what you want in the future. And another thing that people always say is that when I earn a certain amount, I'll start doing things. The truth is, the more you earn, the more likely you're going to change your lifestyle. So say you were buying Nasco cornflakes before, you earn more, Kellogg's is going to start looking more interesting to you. It starts from those little changes, from even like your toilet paper brand that you shop. You say, this one is too coarse for me, you know, let's go for, I worked hard, you know, I earned it. I'll go for a higher end brand for my tissue paper. And those little changes, from even the places that you eat, you start to upgrade. And before you know it, you're still on the same position that you were. It's just that your lifestyle has generally improved, but you do not have money in Robert.
She ain't got no money in the bank. No. She be walking around acting all fine.
This video is not to shame anyone, because trust me, for me, doing this video is more from like a personal experience type thing. I had goals, I had huge money goals, but I wasn't doing anything. I wasn't doing anything concrete to plan for those goals. Meanwhile, I was meeting my business goals. I was exceeding my business goals. But for my personal finance, I was just lukewarm about it. But this year, I was like, you know what? Things are going to change. So the first thing, we're talking about your general spending, and you might want to consider, and that's having a minimum balance in your spending account. So this is just your general savings, the account that you have your ATM card on, the account that you do most of your spending on. So I aspire to have a minimum amount there, regardless of what's going on. I must not spend beyond that amount. So that amount compounds, and when it gets to a certain amount, I can move it to investments. I can move it into emergency funds. So for your general spending account, I would say I use like the traditional bank. So there's nothing special about it. It's just the account that my salary goes into. So the next one to consider is your emergency fund. So anything can happen. For instance, this pandemic is something that wasn't planned for. A lot of people have lost their jobs. A lot of people did not earn an income. And I know this because Lady Biba did not earn an income in about 1.5 months because we had to shut down. So in that period, I didn't have an income. So these are things that you need to plan for. As a 9-to-5 worker, you can lose your job, your company could go under, you could be laid off. As a business owner, your business might have rough periods, but you still need to survive. So you need to build your emergency fund. And for building your emergency fund, I recommend a high interest savings account. So when I say high interest, I'm saying between 5% to 10%. We have banks like Alat, we have Piggy Bank. I use Piggy Bank to build my emergency funds because it's a 10% per annum interest rate when you save with Piggy Bank. And Piggy Bank has, they have options. They have like the auto lock that you can lock money and make more. But for emergency funds, you want to keep it accessible. You want to be liquid. So I use the Piggy Bank Flex to build up my emergency fund. And my emergency fund is not even where it's supposed to be honest, but I'm still building it. And the most important thing is setting money aside so that every month, so that you can keep building it. So a good rule of thumb that I've heard from different people is to have about 3 to 6 months of your monthly salary saved up as an emergency fund. And you don't just want that money sitting down and not doing anything. So that's why I recommend a high interest savings account for that. So the money is there, you're making money on top of your money. So for me, that's a good deal. The next thing in getting your money right is health insurance. And I know you'll be like, oh, what does health insurance have to do with getting my money right? A lot of people end up spending a lot of money when they have serious ailments or sicknesses or diseases. Nobody really knows, anything can happen. So investing in a good health insurance plan is also a way to save your money in the long run. For me, Lady Biba pays my health insurance, and not just me, but Lady Biba staff's our staff's health insurance is covered by the company. So you want to look into options. There's Reliance, HMO, there's Sterling, there's so many options for health insurance out there. All you just have to do is just do your findings, Google it. There's so many plans that are out there. Health insurance is so important. And another thing I'll say is that make sure you review. There's some health insurance plans that are not even worth it. It's just a waste of money because it practically covers nothing. And so you have to find health insurance that's worth your penny. If not, you'll find that most of them are just a waste of time. So do your findings and find the health insurance that works for you. We talked about general savings. We talked about emergency funds. We talked about health insurance. Now we're talking about investments. Investments, I find, is highly subjective. So I wouldn't recommend that you get advice, investment advice, from just one person, especially if the person is not an expert like myself. So I'm just, like I said, I'm a beginner. I'm still learning a lot, and I find that the more that I learn, the smarter and wiser I'm able to make my investment decisions. Some investment outlets that you want to look at, or channels that you want to look at, is shares and stocks. And with shares and stocks, it's amazing today that you can, with an app, you can invest in shares like Apple, Netflix, Shopify, Spotify, Google, Facebook, all the major brands. You can invest in brands like that with an app called Bamboo. There are also other apps like Rise, Chaka, CowrieWise that you can use to invest. Even Piggy Vest has the section in their app that you can use to invest. There are also treasury bills, there's also government bonds, there's also agricultural investment. That's quite the rave now, because you can, I think agricultural investment almost feels scary to me because you're seeing like 30% interest rate over like 7 months. Like the interest rates are high, really, really high, that most of these agricultural investments sell out in hours. So I would say that be careful. You can never be too safe. Make sure that you know your risk appetite. Like, do not invest your emergency funds, or do not invest the money that you end up, like, obviously if you invest money and you lose it, you're going to regret it, but I'm just saying that know what your risk appetite is before you look through those really high interest investments, because the higher the interest, the higher the risk. So be very, very smart in your choices when it comes to investments. Another aspect you might want to consider is real estate. But real estate is when you've got that cash, because unlike these other investments, it is not easy to liquidate. So I feel real estate is something that you can work towards, and it's something that you want to use your disposable income for. It's not something that you want to get your money out like soon. So you need to consider what your plan is, and you can lay out a plan for yourself. You can say, okay, I'm going to use my stock portfolio to build it to a certain point. And when I get to a certain point, I'm going to use that money to buy my first property or whatever. The most important thing is for you to diversify your portfolio. The more diverse your portfolio is, the better for you and the smarter it is for you, because you do not want all your eggs in one basket when it comes to investment. So you need to continuously read. You need to continuously just know about the markets. I've been reading recently about index funds and ETFs, and I don't even know enough to share, but it's an interesting outlet to invest in, because externally traded funds help you to diversify your portfolio. It's a very beginner friendly way of starting investments. And the beauty about some of these apps is that you can invest with even $50. So you need to look into some of these things that I've mentioned. Do not just take my word for it and just go and invest. Please, please, please do your findings. So now we've talked about the ways you can invest, your general savings, emergency funds. Now, the most important thing for me, I believe, is to track your money. And I use an app called Wally to track my money. There are also other ways you can track your money. You can use Excel sheets, you can use Google Sheets, you can download templates online for free, or you can even buy. I know that Patricia Bright, the YouTuber, has a template that she sells. Tony Tone also has a budget template, whatever works for you. For me, I love to have an app that I can just go to, because I spend so much time on my phone anyways. So I like being able to go there. It helps me organize and just streamline everything. Also, you have to have the discipline of going there constantly to put in your receipts, put in your expenses. And I like the app because when you put in your expense, sometimes you're able to find the businesses. If they have their businesses on Google Maps, you can just click on it and then record the expenses. So on the app, I can see how much I spent in a certain business. I can also see, it shows me a graph of like where my money went to. I can see 20% went into groceries, 10% into savings, 20% into investments. So it just gives you like a holistic view of where your money is going to. And I absolutely love that. Another thing that I love about the app also is that I can put in different accounts. So you can put your investment account as well. You can open, say, a Bamboo account. You can open a piggy bank account there. So you can see your assets, you can see your liabilities. The only thing though is you can't put fixed assets in. And even some current assets like a car, for instance, you can't put it in there, but you can put your stocks, you can put your shares, you can put all of that. And then you can see, I love how you can see your net worth in a way, because it shows you your assets, it shows you your liabilities, and then you can see, oh, okay. And even if you have like a personal loan that you're paying back monthly, you can also put it in that app. The app is called Wally. I'll leave a link below in case you're interested in downloading it. All right, I've come to the end of this video. I hope that you found this video helpful, and I hope that we're all making better financial decisions in this 2020. It is the year to get your money right. If you like this type of content, please give this video a thumbs up and share, like, comment, all the good stuff. I'll see you in my next video.